James Bulger, I was always fascinated by, not just where he came from, how he lived, all that, but being able to evade authorities for a good 16, 17 years. Few have done that. And so I was always fascinated with the story. The FBI wanted the Italian mafia in the northern part of Boston. Essentially, what Connolly did was he tried to make a deal with Jimmy that said, look, you help me get the Italian guys, and, you know, maybe we turn a blind eye. You know, as long as you don't do nothing too crazy, turn a blind eye. Well, I think, first and foremost, I think that Jimmy's reaction is that he would never be a rat. You know, he's not going to be a rat for nobody, for nothing. With regard to making that deal, though, I believe that what he was doing, you know, is business. He's not ratting on his own people. He's not, you know, he's look, that's the gang they're against as well. So I think it was a business decision that he made that, without question, worked for him, that he took and ran with. You know, I mean, you're offered that kind of clemency, you're going to take it. Jimmy basically, you know, he went this way, Billy went this way. Billy ends up, you know, this very highfalutin politician. And Jimmy ends up kind of king of the underworld. Yet, they had family dinners, they go to church, even though they were on very distinctly different sides. I'd seen some of Joel Edgerton's work prior to working with him on Black Mass. Getting into the ring with him, you know, was such a joy, because you could throw anything, you know, and he'd knock it back, you know. And that, when you can do that sort of emotional ping pong with another actor, and you recognize in them that they're strong enough to take it, you know, and send it back your way, it becomes this beautiful chess game, you know, in a weird way. It becomes you look forward to it, you know? You look forward to working with people like that. Edgerton, I thought, was brilliant, you know? And there wasn't one scene that we did together that he didn't travel to various places and try new things and try a different way to go. He surprised me every time, and it was a real eye-opener to work with him. I have great respect for him. He's a great, great actor. Billy Bulger, played by Benedict Cumberbatch, who was amazing. Amazing. Just beautiful man, beautiful heart, soul. Benedict and Edgerton absolutely knocked me out. It was such a pleasure working with those guys. Those guys became brothers, you know. They're my brothers. And Benedict, same thing, man. Just came in, killed it. And how giving he is as an actor. How giving they both are, and how appreciative they are. And how, you know, giving in a sense also that, you know, you finish a scene and the guy goes, man, that was killer, great job. You know, I mean, you respect people like that. Scott Cooper is someone that he's like some sort of peculiar, rare star that happens only once in the universe. I mean, I found that remarkable on the set. I mean, I was stupefied by this guy's ability and his vision and his strength of vision and his passion. He ate, drank, slept it. You know, he was constantly thinking, what this, what, you know, how does this fit? Where do I go here? Oh, I got this, and I got, I mean, the dude's amazing. He's a major filmmaker, major talent.